Hello and welcome back to my channel. This week I'm going to be talking about what did I tell my kids after I was diagnosed with cervical cancer. I was afraid of using the word cancer. That word is so heavy and it's so scary and it just takes you instantly in a place that is just not a good place to be. Pretty much everybody knows somebody who's beat cancer and is a cancer survivor, but still, when you find out someone has cancer, it's very scary. And automatically, people think they're not going to make it or something like that. I know when I found out I had cervical cancer, I was scared. What was going to happen to my husband and my kids? How would they get on without me? Do we need to move somewhere else with the smaller house? Do we need to downsize? I mean, all these things were just going through my head. How do I make sure everything's taken care of while after I'm gone? And yeah, I know it's jumping the boat, but that's exactly where I went. I remember after the doctor told me I was saying those things, and she's like, whoa, 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 stop, just stop. We're not even going there. But that's where I went immediately after I found out that I had cancer. I told everybody, I told my family and my boss at work and my closest friends and everything, so they knew what was going on. But what did I tell my kids? I told them everything except for the word cancer. I never used that one word. I told them that I had adenocarcinoma, that I had abnormal cells in my body, that I needed special medicine for in order to kill them off so they can get rid of them, so they stopped growing and just get them out of my body. They knew I was getting radiation and they knew I got chemotherapy. They knew about the port, and my youngest daughter would sometimes tap it, and I'd be like, can you please stop that? It doesn't feel so good. But she always wanted to see it and like touch it and stuff like that, but didn't want to make it too negative, so I just sort of rolled my eyes and went with it. I did stop her every once in a while and ask her, could you please stop? So they knew everything, and they knew what was going on, but I just didn't tell them that one word. Right before I started doing these videos, we went on a walk and I did tell them, do you know everything that I went through and all that stuff? Yeah, well, mommy had cancer. And of course, automatic response is not good. But I was able to say to them, don't panic. Everything's fine. Mommy's fine. They've done testing and they know that nothing's there. In one of my previous videos, I went about unexpected side effects from the radiation, and during my surgery to have the hole put into my cervix so the blood could come out, while they were in there, they took samples, they took biopsies, they tested the blood to make sure nothing funky was going on in there, they took biopsy punches just to make sure that everything was okay, and thank goodness everything came back normal. Not slightly abnormal, completely normal. So that was good. So if I'm having a bad day and I get scared, which happens frequently, I can say, let's take a step back. It's been tested. Pathology is normal. You're fine. Calm down. Everything's fine. And even though I know that, some days I just have a bad day. But back to the original part of the story. Tangent. I was able to tell my girls, I'm fine. Everything's fine. So we had that talk. And they bring it up every once in a while. But it's not really something that we talk about. We'll get past this together as a family. And as a community. So that's it for this video. Very short one, I know. But it's a topic that some people ask me about, is what you tell your kids, and that is what I told my kids. Thank you for joining me. Like, subscribe, and make comments, and I hope you have a great week.